Hey everyone, you don't need 64 gigs of RAM. Even 32 gigs can be overkill. There, I said it, I feel unburdened. Lately, it seems like tech forums and Reddit are full of spec flexing. Hi, I need a PC for my NAN to play Minesweeper. Yeesh, you'll need at least 12 gigs of VRAM and 32 gigs of RAM if your NAN plans on having Chrome open too. OMG, you're so out of date. OP will need at least 16 gigs of VRAM and 64 gigs of RAM at a minimum, unless her NAN enjoys paging. Yeah, so maybe the discussions aren't 100% like that, but they're often close, which is worrying. Here's the thing, 16 gigs of RAM is still fine for the majority of users. Yes, if you want to game in 4K or do video editing, then you'll probably need more. But 16 gigs is usually fine, so ignore some of the grandiose discussions out there. In this video, I wanted to answer a few key questions. When do you need 32 or 64 gigs of RAM? Should you only buy DDR5 nowadays, or is DDR4 still okay to buy? If you don't need loads of RAM, how come some random tech YouTubers task manager shown them using 35 gigs of RAM just from gaming with Chrome open? Finally, I wanted to discuss when it's okay to use the other RAM slots on your motherboard, you know, the other two, to get more RAM on a budget. Before answering how much RAM you need, I wanted to give some reassurance. Steam publishes a monthly survey that summarizes the hardware the Steam users have, and this is a really useful reference. In the most recent survey, you can see that nearly half of all PC gamers have 16 gigs of RAM, with 21% having less than this. And this isn't because the average gamer has ancient hardware. Over half of Steam users have 6 or more CPU threads. I'm assuming this means threads, not cores at least. And many users have fairly recent graphics cards too, with the RTX 3060 being the most popular, and that's a pretty good mid-range GPU. So it's not the case that the 48.5% of 16 gig gamers have really old two-core systems. It's much more likely that 16 gigs is still perfectly fine for the average gamer. Of course, almost 60% of gamers is still using 1080p monitors, only 16% game in 1440p, and less than 4% game in 4K. This is surprising because many tech discussions are flooded with people saying,
"Bros, I just spent one day's wages on a 500Hz 12K monitor and it's the best thing ever to game on! Whee!"
And then you see a dozen people agreeing with this. Okay, I'm exaggerating again. But if you only have a full HD 1080p monitor, then 16 gigs of RAM should be absolutely fine for you, assuming that you're mainly looking to play games. If you want to run professional workloads or edit videos, then you might need a bit more. Equally, if you have a 1440p monitor, then 16 gigs is usually fine, although some recent titles, including Hogwarts Legacy, are starting to recommend 32 gigs when gaming at 1440p and above. What I'd personally recommend for RAM usage is on-screen now, and you can see that I would only really recommend 64 gigs of RAM for 4K, although it's worth noting that this does include doing 4K video editing at a lower resolution, for example, if you edit 4K videos with a 1440p display. But assuming you're not video editing, then 32 gigs or even 16 gigs should be fine for 1440p, and you'll probably struggle to use more than 16 gigs at 1080p. Even though modern releases for games are requiring a lot more memory and VRAM, I think this will still hold true for at least 2 to 3 years. But if you disagree with me or have anything more to add, please let me know down in the comments. Let's turn to the second question. Is it still acceptable to buy DDR4, or should you only buy DDR5 from now? So this is a little tricky to answer because it depends on the hardware you currently have, but also how often you tend to upgrade your system. If you have a 3-year-old Intel system or an AM4 Ryzen motherboard, you're effectively stuck with DDR4 because you can't get DDR5 unless you change the motherboard. This then requires a CPU change and possibly a new CPU cooler too. So it's often a fairly big upgrade. In other words, switching to DDR5 is best achieved when you're effectively buying or building a brand new system. And while a year ago DDR5 systems were still quite expensive, everything has come down in price quite a lot. And so there's a much smaller premium nowadays to be paid to get a DDR5 system, which is great. Having said that though, it does still cost more to go with DDR5 over DDR4. My PC is fairly powerful and I can easily do 4K video editing and gaming in 4K, even though I have DDR4 memory. If you're somebody who changes their motherboard and CPU every 2 to 3 years, then there probably isn't any harm in going with DDR4 memory in 2024. You'll save some money for the next set of upgrades after all. But if the thought of ripping out your motherboard fills you with dread, then just go with DDR5 now and relax. You now have a nice future-proofed system. Let's move on to the third question. How can I say the 16 gigs of RAM is fine when some random TikTok video showed Chrome using loads of RAM? Well, it's because applications will look at how much RAM is available and then pre-reserve some of this for performance reasons. Basically, on an 8 gig system, Chrome might think, oh, I'll just reserve 2 gigs for my use. But on a 64 gig system, Chrome will think, well, hey, there's loads of free memory here, I'll reserve 12 gigs. And then someone does a video saying, I only have 2 tabs open and Chrome's using 22 gigs, they suck. But actually, unused RAM is wasted RAM. And so applications will take chunks of RAM in case they need it in the future, but then quickly release those reserved bits if another application genuinely does need them. Equally, Windows will use free RAM for caching to speed up various parts of the operating system. This is why Windows Task Manager doesn't just say free and used memory, because there's really no such thing. The moment you launch an operating system and then some programs, some RAM is actually used, while a big chunk of RAM is reserved and cached for future performance reasons. So when you see a random TikTok video claiming that you must have 32 or 64 gigs of RAM because their own system barely has any free RAM, you can probably just ignore it. This is also why Linux shows you total, free, used, and buffer or cached memory. By the way, you can't just say this much memory is in use. It just doesn't work like that. The final thing I wanted to discuss is that many motherboards have 4 RAM slots, but various people online say that you should always buy 2 RAM sticks and put them in particular slots, because this then activates dual rank mode and makes them run faster. And these people are right. This is entirely true. However, sometimes this performance benefit is overstated a bit. Some online tests have shown very little difference between running 1, 2, and 4 sticks of RAM. Certainly, let's say that you have 2 8 gig RAM sticks for 16 gigs total, and you're then hitting against RAM bottlenecks because you game at 1440p and you've just installed Hogwarts Legacy. In this case, buying 2 more 8 gig RAM sticks and using all 4 of the motherboard's RAM slots to get 32 gigs of memory in total will be your best option. You might lose a little on dual rank benefits, but freeing yourself of a RAM bottleneck will be a much bigger performance boost. Just make sure that the 2 new sticks of RAM you buy are the same maker model as your old ones. You should never mix and match different RAM brands and speeds, ideally. And that wraps up this video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please click the thumbs up button. Please also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and thanks for watching.